responsible for what you're about to hear. When Tom Strange asked if I could write some new music for a very old instrument, I really wasn't sure what to do. It's very tricky to recast a sound that has such strong historical associations into new circumstances. But meanwhile, at least a year ago, my friend, poet Claire Bateman, had given me a very amusing poem about a class of 24 creative writing students who make, one after another, contrived excuses for the fact that they simply didn't do the assigned reading, a topic upon which I am sure that Claire is an expert. With the stimulus of Tom's request, it occurred to me that the poem would fit nicely into the outlines of a Baroque chamber cantata, a sort of miniature opera for a small ensemble that was in vogue from the late 17th to the mid-18th centuries. I decided to do exactly what I tell my composition students never to do, to compose in a style that really belongs to someone else and to another era. But it allowed me to use the harpsichord in a manner that was sure to be appropriate, playing the continuo part, a characteristic background sound in the Baroque style. And in addition to our wonderful keyboard players, we also have many wonderful singers and string players at the Fine Arts Center that could take part in the project. And besides, Roy has been complaining for the last 25 years that my compositions don't have any tunes he can whistle. So I thought, okay, fine, he's about to retire, I'll let him have one. In my defense, Roy is quite a wonderful artistic director, but maybe not such a great whistler.
You're on the edge, Jim.
I own the stage now. The sequence of brief sections in the cantata is typical of the genre, while the subject matter and the degree of silliness are certainly less typical. The melodic and harmonic language roughly approximate the work of the Baroque master George Frideric Handel on a bad day. You will notice one section in which it actually sounds like Mr. Handel on quite a good day, because I employed a compositional technique that is apparently rather frequently utilized in pop music, that is, plagiarism. Feel free to stand if you feel so motivated. As always, it is deeply gratifying to collaborate with my colleagues Claire Bateman, Brittnee Siemon, and John Ravnan, and with gifted students from across the music department, and I hope you will enjoy our little spoof of the art of verbose teenage rationalization, The Trouble with the Text. Thank you.
Thank you. them weakening with every stroke.
Come on, people, we're ready.
Esperando.
all I had, all I had to hold my breath. But I blinked and sent it flying across the room, flying across the room, flying across the room. I blinked and sent it flying. Flying across the room. The book was so light, I had to hold my breath. 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 The book was so light, I had to hold my breath. But I blinked and sent it flying across the room. I threw it,
he threw it.
The book was so bright, I threw it across the room.
There's no